Greetings. The story I wrote is a story about two women who are in their 80s. In a way, it's a story about grandmothers. And one of the women reminds me of my grandmother. And it's a story about their, what I call, Chevy, you've heard of friendship. Have you heard of friendship? Okay, well, these women don't have a friendship. They have a hate-ship. Okay? So it's the story of their hate-ship. I'll just read a small section. And this section is about a strange funeral, a funeral ceremony. So in this section of the story, a woman has died some years back and has requested to be buried on a specific spot of ground. It is ground that belongs to her family, but because of the history of this country and the forced removals and the Group Areas Act, do you know what those are? Have you heard of those things? The Group Areas Act and the forced removals? Yeah. Because of that, she cannot be buried where she wishes to be buried, which is on her people's land. So this is that ceremony, and I'll just read that short part. It was a small ceremony, although Marion imagined that Anna Marie's funeral would have brought half of Lavender Hill running and the surrounds. Wasn't that what the funeral of an old woman was supposed to be like? An old man, even. Beulah carried a brown earthenware bowl. She came with an old, stooped man who didn't say anything. Marion guessed he was Anna Marie's second husband. Beulah's mother was there and Beulah's younger brother. Hortensia and Marion met them at the gate. They thanked Hortensia in unison. And then they and the small group of friends who joined them all together walked in a jagged line of procession towards the silver tree. The brother dug the hole. Beulah said a few words. Hortensia stayed for the ceremony, then said she had a headache and went back inside. Others mingled around long wooden trellises laid out in the garden. There were cupcakes and cook sisters and hot tea, normal and rooibos and small pies and samosas, and little squares of fudge. Some chairs were spread around, but people mostly stood. Marion got talking with Beulah. Your brother mentioned that you're a lawyer. Beulah nodded. She'd taken a gulp of milky rooibos tea. Do you follow all the land claims? The claims on the land by the people? Some of it. There's a lot. We have one going here, the von Straker's farm. Beulah took another cook sister, finished it, took samosas. She smiled, I'm expecting. Congratulations. Well, Beulah began, my grandmother used to talk about when they moved people off the land. She said about how a lot of old people died, broken-hearted. Some lived on, heartbroken, but alive. Which is worse? Marion didn't know. Sorry to say this, Marion, but it was a wicked thing, scattering people like that. It undid a whole culture of people, made pride difficult. Beulah rubbed her tummy, and Marion noted that there was a small bulge to it. Your people, white people, say to forget it and move on, but we must also get better. Sometimes you move on and you remain sick, and then what is the point of going forward? We must get better too. My grandmother didn't want to forget. I always thought it's because forgetting would be the same as getting lost, not knowing where you are. She told us about this place. Marion's face grew dark. There was a wheel, this big. Beulah raised her hand over her head. Runaways, or a slave man caught with a white woman, or any slave that hit a white person, or stole spoons. Stole something, anything, food. And they'll tie the slave, the person, to the wheel. It was basically designed to break bones. Marion excused herself. Thank you. Mm-hmm.